Very good, Eamonn. So you were quite pleased with all of that?
Oh, the lovely comments are so encouraging. Yeah. It's all so new. It's such a steep learning curve.
Can I just say, before we go any further, thank you very much indeed for the brownies.
Oh, yes!
Did you make these?
I made them this morning.
I mean, it's still not busy enough, and you rustled up a brownie.
How have you...
I didn't want to show up empty-handed, so I thought I'd make you some.
Well, that's very polite.
That's good manners.
And they're gluten-free, if that helps.
Are they?
Whatever they are, they're delicious. The first show, that first live show, I think that when you are sort of thrown into that arena and you're not a dancer, you like dancing, mm-hmm. but it's not something you've ever done before professionally, mm-hmm. what was that moment like?
Completely overwhelming. I think the atmosphere is so electric. It's the biggest dance show in the world. It's such an important moment. You get 90 seconds. We train for hours and hours and hours, and there's 90 seconds to put all that practice out there and perform, and it's a whole new experience, and I'm just so grateful to be doing it.
And they saw potential. I mean, all of the judges said lovely things, and Craig even said some nice things, but they talked about this potential that you mm-hmm. have. Do you believe that? Because I guess that's part of the barrier is getting, you know, sort of fulfilling that potential.
I hope so. Well,
I think you definitely have potential. I was just like, even from the day one, just learning step.
How did you feel when you were paired up, first of all? Because you need someone tall.
Mm-hmm. Emma was actually livid. She was absolutely...
How tall are you?
5'8".
5'8", right, yeah, OK. So... And so that clicked together? Was it mm-hmm. immediate?
It was, because I'm in heels, I'm 6. So...
heels am I doing?
But the good thing is, when you're partnered up with Aljaz, you kind of get Jeanette thrown in as well.
Which
though
I
she's
love.
Got mm-hmm. her own partner. I
mean, the dream team, yeah.
It is
household.
How lucky.
You think she's given you lots of help
so
as well.
Much. We FaceTimed her mum immediately. We were so excited. And we it's incredible, the support. I'd say they should be motivational speakers, because we're experiencing this whole range of emotions, and they're so solid and so supportive.
Well, she calmed you down.
Yeah.
In what way? Where was that?
Because you just don't know how you're meant to feel. I think, you know, it's so exciting, and then you doubt yourself. I'm very hard on myself. That's my biggest flaw, and I need to work on that.
It's not a flaw. I think it's a good thing. It's a good thing.
Yeah. As long as you harness those things properly, and you had the tango was last week, and you, I mean, you look at you, and you're so beautiful, and you're very elegant. And you're also very fit. I mean, I know you work out an awful lot. So doing the tango, you said, was actually... Your body sort of had to get in positions that it's never got in before.
Totally. It's a whole new discipline. The way you have to hold your frame. You can hear him shouting at me, stay up!
You know what? I'm really happy that we're doing... It's my favourite dance.
Yeah.
And it's really lovely when you get a chance to do sort of two ballroom dances back-to-back, because you can work on a frame, you can keep sort of building on it. And it's a beautiful... music from the theme song from the Downton Abbey.
Oh, yeah.
And it's so powerful. We actually cried when we heard it for the first time. Because you never really sort of hear the whole piece. You always sort of just hear like 10 or 20 seconds of it. And it's a beautiful piece of music, and I couldn't wait.
I didn't know that there was 90
it's,
seconds
it's
of
so
Downton
lovely.
Abbey's
it's,
music.
It's 90, 85, no more. It's more.
Well, I mean, this, you must think of similar sorts of pieces of music every time you drive down your drive, surely. I mean, Longley is, like Highclere, it is a beautiful building.
Yeah.
It's absolutely stunning. So I mean, and I'm assuming that you've got to, with the work on the dance floor, you've got to tie that in with work on the estate as well.
Yeah, I'm always up and down that motorway. Late, because my two children, they're 2 and 4 years old, so I read them bedtime stories, I put them to bed, and then I get in the car and drive up to London to be at work the next day, or vice versa. Gosh. So your ordinary life doesn't go away, but this is all-consuming, and I care so much and so passionately, and I'm so grateful for all your hard work and patience. So you've just got to balance it out. And
so are you splitting time between sort of Longley and London? So you've got sort of travelling to Wiltshire. Do you sometimes train down in Wiltshire as well?
Yeah,
we trained
there yesterday, and today we're in London, and then hopefully next week the same.
Yes. Yeah. So when I read this morning that you had been down and you practiced at Longley, I was quite surprised. I have these pictures in my head of what it might be like when you drive, because we did this whole show live from Highclere, which was stunning, and everyone was so sweet to us. It's been a long time since I was at Longley. I would imagine when you go down there training that I thought they'd be in the ballroom. There must be a ballroom.
We are actually
you were in the village hall.
We're in the village hall of Horningsham, which is the stunning little place. Yeah. It's such a pretty little... it has a really lovely charm
very
to it.
Sweet.
And the best thing is, it's so peaceful. Mm-hmm. Normally, when we rehearse in London, you sort of train in those studios that it's right in the middle of the town. Mm-hmm. But our little village hall, it's in the middle of nowhere.
No, we've gone to a space with a proper wooden floor.
Yes.
We've hired in mirrors, boring mirrors. from someone. And yeah, so we're working hard in this lovely village hall.
So do you, I mean, at this stage, I mean, obviously you had the elimination, the first one last week. You want to go as far as you can go. Everyone sort of thinks about Blackpool as the first one, and then you want to get to Halloween, and then obviously you set your eyes on that glitter ball trophy. Are you glimpsing that far? What are you hoping for?
Just making progress, working hard. I didn't come into this at all as a dancer, so every week is such an enormous learning curve, and I'm so grateful to everyone who voted for us to keep us in, to keep us working together and to carry on. It's the most incredible experience. Yeah. I'm really so grateful and loving it so much, and I, of course, want it to last as long as we possibly can. And I never... It makes me cry, but I never want to let you down.
Never.
I'm not going to cry,
never.
I promise,
never.
But that's my main concern.
You know, for you, we always say this to the pros when they come in here, that but yes, you want a great partner. You want someone that's not going to get you knocked out week one, because you guys want to win it just as much. There is competition between the pros.
I think there is to some extent, but I think we're all, at first, just really lucky that we are a part of Strictly. It's the best...
Yeah.
No, I actually genuinely mean it.
No. It's been 2013 dances... since you picked up that trophy.
Has it?
Yeah.
Time flies when you have fun, you know?
So you're telling me that you're really not... It's just nice to be part of the team.
Yes. I'm actually genuinely honest with you here. Like, honestly, like, that phone call every single year when we find out if we are back or not is the most stressful 10 minutes of my life every single year, because... We love the job so much to create on a platform like Strictly, to choreograph for millions of people watching. Where else can you get that? And for a dancer, there is not really a better thing to do, if I'm honest with you. Not nowhere in the world there is a bigger Dancing with the Stars than there is here in UK. Yeah. Mm. And the way the British public loves dancing, it's unheard of.
But would you like to win?
Always. You know what? Well, to answer the question. Yeah. Yes.
It's so lovely to see you
on Saturday. Yeah. Willoughby watching. I love it so much. So, yeah, enjoy it. Try to enjoy it.
Keep those nerves at bay. I'm loving it more than anything.
Strictly, it's Saturday at 7 on BBC One. The results show is on Sunday. Don't watch that, because I'm on the other side.
Right, we are taking
it back to the wrapping. Keep dancing.